This week on Maker Update, elevating your workspace, the iceberg that sunk the Titanic, getting medieval, and look mom, no CAD. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where you go to keep up to date on all the great things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a super fun show for you, so let's start off with the project of the week. Workshops, by their nature, just aren't the best places to do computer work. They're dusty, they're loud, and they probably don't have a dedicated space for this kind of work. So you end up like this. But when you have as many digital fabrication tools as Morley Kert does, computer work is inevitable. But he doesn't want to give up any of the floor space for an office pod, so he's building up instead of out. And what he's building is this geodesic dome office pod that bridges the gap between his enclosure for a CNC router and 3D printers. And both of those machines are going to do a lot of the heavy lifting on this build. The spars for the dome are all cut on the router, and the connecting pieces and bushings are all 3D printed. The floor and the back panel are made from joined plywood, so they're plenty sturdy. But the routed and printed structure of the dome is surprisingly sturdy as well, enough that he can hang his own weight from them. It probably goes without saying that designing a geodesic dome into a functioning workspace is no easy feat. But they're even trickier than they seem, and there's a lot of subtle geometry to them that isn't apparent. All these triangles, they're not equilateral. And these two sides are just a little bit longer than this one. There's some modularity built into his design, since each spar of the triangle is its own piece of wood, but he's still got to be paying close attention when assembling, and it does catch him out a few times. And while he's going to be adding finishing touches to his new workspace for a while, what he ends up with looks incredible. He's got a cozy workspace in his shop, and the fact that it looks like he's in the cockpit of a starship makes it better than any regular office space. He's already adding in some ventilation since he is directly above his 3D printers and he wants to be ready for the summer months when the weather gets warmer. It's a tremendous build and a great video. More projects. Keeping with the theme of elevated spaces, Rachel Maksy was given the opportunity to do some installation work at her friend's photography studio, Phalite Forge. They just created this loft space in the studio, and it's Rachel's job to give it a fantasy-themed makeover to suit the sort of photography that they do there. Insulation foam boards become stone walls, along with faux wooden beams to break up the pattern. This is a lot like watching Nerdforge's epic book nook build, but on a life-size scale. The solution for the studio door is especially clever. Since the studio is a rented space, the occupants aren't allowed to paint the door. This modern door just ruins the illusion. But they can add a facade to the door, and that's exactly what Rachel does. The final reveal is gorgeous and the result of several days of work, but it really does sell the illusion of being transported back in time. Cardboard Studio made this simple but outstanding mechanical game of steering the Titanic around icebergs. And true to their name, this is made almost entirely out of cardboard. The sea and the field of ice are on an endless loop of craft paper held taut by spools made from cardboard. The output of this DC motor is geared down using some Lego gears, and the ship steers by being pulled around on this magnet on this pulley system. The ship's helm is a great touch for the steering mechanism, and the finished game looks incredibly polished. It's a fun, minimalist build that should be within the reach of anybody. From Spark's Curiosity, we have a 3D printable manual knitting machine, and it's entirely open source and customizable. If you want to get knitting straight away, you can download the STLs and start printing. But if you want to make any changes, you can go to our GitHub repo and get access to the OpenSCAD files for the project. In her thorough video, she offers some great tips for printing out the parts, how to assemble the machine, the correct knitting needles to use, and how to navigate the SCAD files. And of course, how to use the machine. Time for some tips and tools. One of the best uses for a 3D printer is the ability to create custom organizers to suit your exact needs. but learning CAD can still be a big roadblock for some folks. Christiana from Get Hands Dirty is in that camp, which is why she put out this video with several tips on how you can still get this done without touching a CAD application. Chief among which is a website called Bento3D, which allows you to create 3D printable custom boxes in just a few clicks. There's even options for stackable boxes. Check it out. Over on Instructables, I saw this guide for a new technique for etching glass on a CO2 laser cutter by rschoenm. This engraving technique allows you to create super dark line work instead of the traditional frosted look. First, you mix up a paste of titanium dioxide, water, and white glue. Spread that onto the glass you're going to engrave and let it dry. When the engraving is complete, clean off the mixture using water and a toothbrush, leaving behind your black engraved glass. It's a cool look. If you've been on the fence about learning FreeCAD but held back by the steep learning curve, check out AstoCAD. AstoCAD is a fork of the FreeCAD project with the intent to make some huge improvements to the UI and usability to make it friendlier to newcomers. AstoCAD actually runs on top of FreeCAD, so any updates to FreeCAD will be immediately rolled into AstoCAD. Unfortunately, unlike FreeCAD, the development of AstoCAD is funded by a membership program to access the software. But if you're up for helping develop the software, it looks like it offers some really great features. And finally, Adam Savage offers up some advice on how to stay positive in the current global environment. The world has been a pretty chaotic and distressing place lately, and it's been pretty hard for a lot of people to stay focused and stay positive and productive. Limiting his access to news feeds, remembering that he has a responsibility to stay focused and provide for his family, and also considering how lucky he is to have the opportunity to do the work that he's doing and to be able to have positive interactions with fans, no matter how much his beliefs differ from theirs. Some of this advice may be specific to his situation, but I think there's a lot of good lessons here. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Zach the Byte-Sized Engineer has a collection of tips and things he'd wish he'd known sooner in his engineering career. How to use a logic analyzer. Why you should label everything. Using deburring tools on his 3D prints. Tips for hot glue. There's just tons of useful advice in here. Plus, there's a bonus lightning round with a tight collection of soldering tips. Check it out. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. A reminder that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by checking out the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment and tell us about your favorite project. And give us a thumbs up and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. As always, huge thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.